Attack on Titan is amazing, that's a no-brainer. But what makes AOT so good? Is it the hype opening after opening each season? Or is it seeing Levi being built differently every scene? While both are great, the core of Attack on Titan boils down to Isayama's brilliant writing. Let's take a closer look. At the current time of this recording, Attack on Titan is currently airing its final season. Within 5 episodes, AOT is sitting at the second highest rated anime on MAL, and I expect it to be number 1 after the season is finished. If you are an anime only watcher, don't be worried about any spoilers, as I will only be covering everything up to the current anime episode. If you haven't started watching the final season, however, I suggest you save this video for later. There's a lot to analyze for Attack on Titan, so this video will be part 1 of a 5-part series taking a closer look at Isayama's brilliant writing. For this series, I will be analyzing 5 recurring ideas. The first idea is the theme of freedom, which we will be taking a look at in this video. The theme of freedom is shown heavily through the parallels of Reiner versus Eren. The second idea is fear of the unknown, shown through Gabi's embodiment of Marley in contrast to Paradis. The third idea is utilitarian philosophy. We will be taking a closer look at the similar philosophy between Zeke and the race family. The fourth idea is the burden of a leader, shown through Erwin, Hanji, and Armin. The fifth idea is coming of age, shown through Historia's characterization in the Armored Titan arc. In 2013, if you asked anyone what they thought about Attack on Titan, the common consensus would be, it's okay, it looks like the typical shonen entertainment with very surface level themes and ideas. However, little did people realize that the reason for this is because the first 2 seasons were only a prologue to develop the main idea of Attack on Titan, which was revealed in Season 3, Part 2. I would describe the first 2 seasons as a necessary setup to create a backbone and foundation for all the characters and the story. People were unable to see the entire picture because everything presented to them was only through the small lens of the first 2 seasons. However, at the time of airing, even though it could lead to the series being perceived negatively, I believe this was an intentional decision made by Isayama to portray the idea of freedom. More on that later. With the introduction of the third season, Part 2, AOT started garnering massive attention when the true plot was revealed. That being the different dynamics between the Marleyans, Eldians, and the inhabitants of Paradis. Since the reveal of the true plot, AOT has become one of the highest rated shows on MAL. To summarize, just read the manga, bro. But in all seriousness, now let's talk about the idea of freedom. When analyzing the idea of freedom portrayed by Isayama, there are no 2 characters that resemble freedom more than Eren and Reiner. To understand how both characters creates contrast to freedom, we must take a road trip back to Season 1 to see how it all began. At the start of Season 1, we see Eren's mom being eaten by a titan, which incites a fire within Eren, swearing to get revenge and break free from the walls protecting them. Eren believes that everyone living within the walls are not free, that at any point, a titan could break the wall and end humanity. Humans were trapped sheep, unable to escape and explore the vast world ahead of them. Freedom is what was taken away by the titans. That is what freedom was painted as in Season 1 of Attack on Titan. We can see a clear black and white outline of the situation. Titans are the bad guys because they are oppressing humans, and humans are the good guys because they are fighting for what is right. Thus, in Season 1, we can clearly see the good and the bad and the black and the white. However, as the seasons start to progress, the good and the bad start to become questionable, and the black and the white start to become gray. As Eren and the other Survey Corps start fighting back and achieving freedom, their worldviews begin to shift. At the very beginning, when Eren was trapped within the walls, he could only see a small portion of what was ahead. Similar to taking the blue pill and finding out the truth, or taking the red pill and living in blissful ignorance, Eren and us viewers in Season 1 were living in blissful ignorance. However, after Eren decided to take the blue pill and fight for freedom and the truth, he realized that not everything was as black and white as he originally thought. Back to the idea I said earlier about Attack on Titan Season 1 and 2 not being received well by the community, I said that this was an intentional decision made by Isayama. As Eren climbs up the ladder of freedom and learns knowledge and the truth, so do us viewers. We begin to see the world from a higher platform. it is up until season 4 that we finally understand the journey from the bottom of freedom to the top. Us viewers are experiencing Aaron's journey alongside with him. We do not know any key information that would change our views and only know what Aaron knows. We as viewers are alongside Aaron in season 1, seeing him pursue the only goal of killing all the Titans. Along the journey, however, we instead see him develop into someone who questions what is right from what is wrong. With a very narrow view in season 1, we have the opinion that all the Titans are bad. We see Reiner and Bertholdt as villains who destroyed the lives of Aaron and civilians. But as we broaden our view seeking freedom, we find out the truth about Reiner and Bertholdt and begin to question, are they really in the wrong for committing these actions? Statements like, he is wrong and I am right, become questions like what should be right or is this justified? This is where the juxtaposition and contrast between Reiner and Aaron really emphasize freedom. The two represent polar opposites on the line of freedom. On one hand, you have Aaron, devoid of freedom, fighting to get it back. And on the other hand, you have Reiner, knowing the entire truth, full of freedom, questioning and hesitating if his actions are justified. This leads to the discussion on the price of freedom. No character than Reiner is more fitting to be the embodiment to the price of freedom. At the start of season 4, Reiner's motivation behind his actions were revealed, that he infiltrated Paradis as part of an operation to retrieve the founding Titan. From then on, we get to see the development of Reiner as he gets to interact with members of the Survey Corps. As someone who was taught that everyone in the island of Paradis are devils, he realizes that this is not the case. The more he interacts with the civilians of Paradis, the more he realizes that they are the same as Marleyans and Eldians. Whatever damage Reiner and his crew has caused brought grief to many innocent civilians that didn't deserve it. Reiner knows that if he just thinks of the civilians of Paradis as devils, then he would feel less guilty, that whatever he was taught in Marley, if he stuck to that mindset, it would be alright. This is the burden and price of freedom. Reiner is trying to hide from the truth after seeing the ugliness of the world. Freedom isn't beautiful, it's gray. Coming to terms with the fact that you are killing innocent civilians and humans that are similar to you is what Reiner, who sought freedom, must burden. Reiner, who wants the Eldians to be free, must kill innocent civilians in order to accomplish his dream. Isayama questions the audience. Who is right? Who is wrong? But those questions are not simple to answer once you see the whole picture. That is what Isayama is trying to get at. It's not black and white. The opening to the fourth season of Attack on Titan presents a rather gloomy and gray opening. This places a commentary that not everything is as black and white as it seems. Marley isn't a villain and Paradis isn't a hero. Both sides have reasons for their actions and both struggle to come to terms with justification for their actions. Is it okay to kill the innocent people of Paradis if it means that the Eldians can be free? No other scene further emphasizes the struggle at the top of freedom, as does when Reiner talks to his family about his trip to Paradis. As Reiner recollects his long tenure on the island, he begins by stating that everyone were real demons, inhumane even. He recollects about the time Sasha once stole a potato and offered half of it to the instructor, about one who'd forgotten why he went to the bathroom, and about one guy who charged into any situation without thinking. To me, this was one of the most powerful scenes of Attack on Titan. It really shows the struggle of Reiner. As Reiner recollects these memories, you can see his hand on his face trying not to laugh. He tries his best to paint them as demons, but knows deep inside that none of them have done anything to deserve this. He feels bad about everything that he's done to cause harm to them. Freedom comes with the price that you understand the impact of all your actions. But as much as Reiner struggles, he still loves his home of Eldians more than anything. He does not want Gabby and Falco to end up going through the same path as him. That lies at the core of his determination. He wants Gabby and Falco to remain aloof and ignorant, as this is what will make them the happiest. Not everyone can take the path towards freedom. Some refuse to get hurt, others struggle at the top. Reiner is someone who is willing to take all the burden of knowing the truth to shelter his friends and family from ugliness in order for them to be happy. Now comes the most interesting scene in season 4, when Aaron shifts into a Titan when talking to Reiner. History will always repeat itself. What goes around comes around. Aaron is going through the exact same journey as Reiner. Aaron has forced himself to label the people of Marley as villains in order to protect his friends and the civilians of Paradis. As someone who wants to see his friends smile, he declares war on Marley. Aaron repeats what Reiner did to the civilians of Paradis, and we get this epic cover art of Season 4. Now tell me if you notice a difference between Season 1 and Season 4. The roles are reversed, but now that we know the whole situation, who is right and who is wrong? In Season 1, when we were fighting for freedom, the answer is obvious. Titans are bad. But in Season 4, when we have freedom, and when the exact same situation occurs again, who is right and who is wrong? The truth is gray, and we must bring forth justification in order to pursue actions. The people at the top of freedom must pay the heavy price of being burdened with the lives of innocent civilians lost. That is the price Aaron and Reiner must pay. Attack on Titan is great. Isayama takes the audience on a journey through the lens of a young Aaron seeking freedom, only to show that the expected outcome is not so simple. My favorite panel of Attack on Titan is when the Survey Corps finally sees the ocean for the first time. The world is vast. If you stay ignorant behind the walls of Paradis, you might be happy, but will you ever be free? Would you have enough strength to seek what is behind the ocean? Thanks for watching the first part of a 5-part series on the analysis of Attack on Titan. Reiner is one of my favorite characters in Attack on Titan, and I hope you guys were entertained and learned something from this video. The next theme I will be analyzing is the fear of the unknown shown through Gabby. If you enjoyed this video, drop a like and comment your thoughts. If you disliked, comment below and I'd be happy to discuss with you. This has been Hyacinth, and part 2 will come out soon. Peace.